In the previous lesson, we learned how we can create rectangles. However, next to the rectangle icon, there's an arrow. Once you click on this arrow, a short drop-down menu appears, and as you can see, there we can find the Polygon tool. The Polygon tool can be also found in the Draw menu, like the rest of the drawing tools. And of course, we can just type the word Polygon in the command line and press Enter to activate it. Before I activate the tool, I would like to mention that for the following exercise, a drawing with two auxiliary circles has been created to help you understand the difference between an inscribed and a circumscribed polygon. I also have to mention that for this exercise, the center snap is necessary since I wish the center of the polygons to coincide with the center of the auxiliary circles. Now it's time to finally activate the Polygon tool. Once the tool is active, the first thing I have to do is to define how many sides the polygon is going to have. In AutoCAD, a polygon can have between 3 and 1024 sides. Firstly, I will create a hexagon, so I will type the number 6 and press Enter to define the number of its sides. Next, a message prompts me to specify the center of the polygon. I will move the cursor on the circle, and once the center snap appears, I will click on it. After the center's definition, I have to choose whether the polygon will be inscribed in the circle or circumscribed about the circle. Let's begin with the inscribed option. I will select inscribed in circle and then type the number 10 to define the radius of the circle which the polygon will be inscribed in. Lastly, I will press Enter to create the polygon. Now I will repeat the same procedure, only this time I will select the circumscribed option. I will start by selecting polygon again. I will press Enter to accept that the polygon will have 6 sides. The number 6 was already written in this field because AutoCAD shows as the default value the last number I had entered in a certain field. I will move the cursor on the other circle, and once the center snap appears, I will click on it. This time, I will select the circumscribed about circle option, and then type the number 10 to define the radius of the circle which the polygon will be circumscribed in. Then, I will press Enter to create the second polygon. Notice the difference between the inscribed and circumscribed options. Naturally, there's no need to create auxiliary circles beforehand in order to create polygons. To prove my point, I will activate Polygon again. This time, I want to create a polygon with 3 sides. As you may have imagined, a polygon with 3 sides is basically a triangle. And since it's going to be either inscribed or circumscribed in a circle, it's going to be an equilateral triangle, which means that its sides will have the same length. So, I will type the number 3 and press Enter to define the sides. After that, I will click on a random space in the drawing area to define the center of the polygon. Next, I will choose the inscribed in circle option and set the radius of the imaginary circle as 10. By the time I press Enter, an equilateral triangle has been created like it was expected. Based on the same principle, a polygon with 4 sides will be a square. With the Polygon tool active once again, I will type the number 4 and press Enter to define the sides of the polygon. Then, I will click somewhere in the drawing area to define its center. I will select the circumscribed option and set the radius of the imaginary circle as 10 again. When I press Enter, a square was created. At this point, I have to mention that in the last two examples of polygon, whether I chose the inscribed or the circumscribed option would have made little difference.